you doing? It's your girl Tasha. I'm coming to you with another album review. Today we're going to do two albums. Yes, you're getting two for one. It's a special that I'm doing over here at Tasha TV. All right, we're going to talk about Dedrick Haddon's Church on the Moon album, as well as Kirk Franklin's newly released Hello Fear. Let's get into it.
Just like music.
Dedrick Haddon released Church on the Moon. I don't know what album this is for him because he has, you know, quite an extensive catalog. He doesn't have just solo albums. He also has a choir that he performs with, Voices of Unity, and so they do albums as well. And Dedrick's been doing music for a little bit. But I was excited about Church on the Moon when I heard the title. I was like, where is he going with this? I want to be there for it, okay? So I picked it up, like I said, at the beginning of March. You guys, this is a great album. I really love it. It's a great balance for me, in my opinion, between the contemporary, you know, urbanized gospel music. And then there are some of my favorite songs on the album, surprisingly, are his more traditional sounding type gospel songs. My favorite song is Mighty God, and I also like Well Done. You guys may have heard Well Done if you watch The Stellars. He performed that on the Stellar Awards. He also performed it if you watch the NAACP Image Awards, you know, where he was wearing the white glasses and the white outfit with the gloves. Yeah, his outfit sometimes, I think when he performs that song, his outfit, you know, distracts from that song, and so people can't totally get all the way into it, but it is an awesome song. I love the lyrics. I just like, you know, the first lyric, I just want to make it to heaven. Really cool song. Reppin' the Kingdom, which features J Moss, Ty Tribbett, and Canton Jones. They're all doing like this T-Pain singing, rapping, auto-tuning kind of thing on it, but it's really awesome. I like J Moss when he's doing this kind of like rap singing thing because he's just really good at it, in my opinion. That's what I think. Some of the other tracks that I really like on this album, of course, the title track, Church on the Moon, it's really nice. The drum sounds to it kind of remind me of, you guys remember Truth Hurts and the song, I don't remember how the song goes, but look up Truth Hurts. I think it's so contagious. I think it might be called Addictive. I don't know. Yeah, I think that's what it is. Truth Hurts, Addictive. You know how the drums went in there? Okay, that's how. So like I said, if you guys want to check out Dedrick Haddon's Church on the Moon, I think it's a great album. At least give it a listen to through the previews on iTunes if you're kind of iffy about it. It offers something for everybody. You get some really good vocals from Dedrick Haddon. He has not skipped out on that. One track in particular, Baby You're a Star, he really goes in vocally on that track, as well as emotionally. Like when I listen to that track, I feel like I'm in the studio with him, watching him perform this song or record this song. So I really like how organic it is and how organic the sound on that track is. But if you also like some of the more urbanized hip-hoppy kind of stuff, go ahead and check out other tracks like King, Gravity, Bended Knees, Forgiven, Showstopper, and Power, okay? So there's a ton of tracks on this album. You guys get it, check it out. I'm gonna give this album a 3.5 stars out of 5. I think he did pretty good. Four, I think it's close to a 4 only because, I don't know, what I give it 4? I don't know if I'm at a 4 status with this album. But okay, let's just change that. We're gonna do like Star Search, and I'm gonna give him 3.75 stars. He's very close to 4. Okay guys, on March 22nd, Kirk Franklin released his 12th album entitled Hello Fear. With the catalog this extensive, it's kind of hard to say if this is his best album. For me, this is my favorite album that I have of Kirk Franklin. I have about 3 or 4 other of his albums, and like I said, this one is my favorite. What I really like about this album is the concept and how all the songs really mesh well in content, and they also just seem to integrate really well into each other. I mean, it's a smooth transition going from one song to another during most of this album, and maybe except for a couple of songs where you kind of just switch vibes, but they all are on this constant theme, this same kind of pattern, and it seems like it kind of takes you on an emotional trip, you know, okay, where somebody is walking with you step by step through each one of these tracks. I really, really, really am digging this album. Okay, so some of my favorite songs on this album. Of course, I like Before I Die. We saw him perform this at the opening of the Celebration of Gospel, BET. I didn't really get into it all that much when I saw it for the first time on BET. That was because mainly I really couldn't understand what they were saying in the lyrics, and I really wasn't paying that much attention to the performance, but I did enjoy it from what I saw. So I was really happy to, you know, get a chance to really dig in and dive in onto this song, and it's become one of my favorite songs. Like, when I cut this album on, it's usually the first track that I listen to. Of course, there's also I Smile, which is the lead single off of this album. It became one of my theme songs just because I could really relate to the content and the theme of the song, you know. Even though things may not be looking really good, I still have a smile on my face. A couple other songs that I really like on this album, Everyone Hurts. When I saw the title of this, I thought it was going to be a remake to R.E.M. Everyone, is it was Everybody Hurts? Yeah, R.E.M. is Everybody Hurts. This one for Kirk Franklin is Everyone Hurts. But I thought that he was gonna mesh it and kind of do like a sampling of the R.E.M. song, but it's not, and that's fine because I really do like this. It seems kind of organic to me. One thing about this album, I did not know that there were gonna be like a few live tracks on here, like Give Me featuring Molly Music. I really do like that. Though I will have to say, maybe the first or second time that I listened to the track Give Me, Molly Music's voice just became kind of irritating. You know, he has a unique voice. If you heard Molly Music, you know what I'm talking about. But if you haven't heard him, you may feel like he's not really a singer or a vocalist. He just has a unique voice that does sound well when he does music. But it kind of got on my nerves a little bit during this track. But nonetheless, I'm over that now, and I do like the track. Another song on the album that I really like, classic Kirk Franklin, Something About Jesus Part 2. I thought that they were going to use the same beat and the same melody as the first one and this one, but they didn't. They kind of flipped it up and they switched it, which was refreshing, and I did enjoy it. This song is featuring Rance Allen, of course, along with John P. Key, Marvin Winans, and Isaac Carey. They all do a great job in leading this song, and I just really like it. It's, you know, it's talking about, let's get to know Jesus. Let me tell you about Jesus. So I just like that song, and it's really good. And at the end, you do get the classic shoo-doo-doo-doo. Yeah, so y'all need to check that out, all right? Thumbs up for my vocals. Y'all know y'all like it. So that's it for Kirk Franklin's Hello Fear. You guys need to go check that out. Out of the two, I'm actually going to give Kirk Franklin a 4 on this album, a 4 out of 5, because I really do like this. I think it's really, it's just, to me, it's classic Kirk Franklin, but it's a refreshed classic Kirk Franklin. You know, a lot of people nowadays have been saying that, you know, people like Dedrick Haddon and Kirk Franklin and Mary Mary are getting a little too worldly. They're going a little too secular. They're trying to be more of entertainers than ministers. If you are thinking that way about these artists, I would really say, especially with this Kirk Franklin album, give it another listen, because these guys have definitely not lost, you know, their focus on Christ, and they know what their mission and their gift and their purpose is in life to do. And this is what they're doing, you know. So that's it, my reviews for Kirk Franklin's Hello Fear and Dedrick Haddon's Church on the Moon. Make sure you guys go by and pick those up in your local stores. If not, you can go ahead and download them off of iTunes, all right? I thank y'all for watching this video. Make sure you drop your comments below. Let me know what you think. Also, share this on Facebook and on Twitter. Follow me on Twitter and Facebook. Thank you for watching. I love you. God loves you. And...